Today we're going to take a look at leveling your turning center. This is the basis from which the machine maintains its geometry, accuracy, and ability to produce good finishes. If it's been a while since the level was checked on your machine, we're going to show you how to get it done, so stick around. When we install a lathe, it must be leveled to a certain height to provide optimum performance and accuracy and attain proper coolant and chip flow. There are a few tools required for this job: a 3/4 inch socket, a 1/2 inch drive ratchet, a 1.5 inch box wrench, a large tape measure, a mag base, and a precision level. We recommend using a machinist level with 2 vials. We'll start by making sure the machine is at the correct height as specified on the decal. If the machine is too high on the pucks, this can risk excessive vibration. If it's too low, you may have a problem getting the coolant tank in place or not being able to get the wheels of a Haas shoplift under the machine. For this machine, we're going to maintain 3 inches from the ground to the bottom of the casting on all 4 leveling screws. For larger frame machines with 6 or 8 leveling screws, the middle screws should not be touching the pads during the initial step of the leveling process. Put the level on a flat surface, like a tailstock or a granite table. Pay close attention to the bubble. If the bubble is off, use the adjuster to correct the bubble. Some levels use a knob and some use a set screw and an Allen key to adjust the bubble. We will use 2 vials to measure the X and Z axis respectively. We will position the long vial parallel to X axis. This will allow us to measure the twist along the Z axis or side to side. We'll use the short vial to measure the tilt of the machine left to right. This influences how the coolant drains from the machine. Once the level is calibrated, jog the X axis to the middle of travel and the Z towards the operator door so you can gain access to the turret. Place the large mag base on the face of the turret. Take the level you have just calibrated and place it on top of the mag base. Tap the bottom of the mag base around until the bubble is centered in the large vial. When leveling the machine, always raise the machine to keep pressure on the leveling screws and maintain clearance for the coolant tank. Raise the front right leveling screw so it's not touching the pads. Looking at the short bubble, we need to raise the right rear leveling screw to bring the bubble to the center of the vial. Now, look at the bubble in the large vial, which is parallel to the X-axis. Raise the front left leveling screw to bring the bubble to the center of the vial. The machine is now rough leveled, but what we just did only take care of the height, chip flow, and coolant drain. Now we need to check for twists. This is the area of the leveling process that will make all the difference in the world to how your machine performs. Since twists compromise the geometry of your machine, it can introduce error into machine parts and leave them out around. Let's start by correcting the twist. Basically, we're checking to see if the bubble in the large vial changes direction from front to back and vice versa as we move along the Z-axis. Start with the Z-axis at the spindle head and the large vial parallel to X. Look at the bubble in the large vial. It should be in the center of the vial. Jog the Z-axis towards the home position and look at the bubble to see the low point. We can see that the bubble has moved the right side of the vial, meaning that the rear side is higher than the front. Raise the front right leveling screw to raise the machine until the bubble is in the center of the vial. Now, let's jog Z-axis back to the spindle head side and recheck the bubble in the large vial. Here again, we will raise the low side either at the front or back screw until the bubble is in the center of the vial. As you can see, we're bringing up the low side at each end of travel until the level shows the same side-to-side reading across the full z-axis travel. Repeat this process until the bubble stays center across the full travel. Remember, up until now, machines with center leveling screws, those screws have not been touching their pads. For machines with center screws, we'll use the ratchet to turn the leveling screws about 10 degrees to apply pressure to the center pads, front and rear. With all leveling screws touching their pads, run the Z-axis from the spindle side to the home position one more time to ensure there is still no movement from the bubble and no twist in the machine. Once the machine level is complete, use the jam nut to lock the leveling screws in place. Hold the leveling screws in place while you tighten the jam nut. The machine is now level and free from twist. We recommend doing this every 6 months to a year. And remember, for more information on service and maintenance, visit HaasCNC.com/service, and thanks for watching.